Orange Man, he may be bad in the eyes of the media, but he's not so bad in the eyes of Republican voters, because the last poll, the most recent poll to come out, Morning Consult Politico, says if the 2024 Republican presidential primary were being held today, for whom would you vote? And it's Donald Trump, 47%. And nobody else is even on the radar. The next closest, Pence and DeSantis, are tied at 12% each. Donald Trump Jr. comes in fourth at 6%. Nikki Haley, she gets a lot of play in the press, 3%. Tim Scott, he gets a lot of play, 1%. Mike Pompeo, 0%. It's still Trump's party.
Oh, it's Trump's party. And that poll actually does not shock me. Who can still bring out the rallies? Who does the base still love? Who is still fighting the machine, even though he's not on social media and he's just got these silly press releases and everything else? It's still Trump. You know, Megan, you know, I didn't vote for Trump the first time around. I did vote for him the second time around. In a weird way, I'm more proud that I voted for him now than even when I voted for him, because look how horrible everything is. It didn't mean he was perfect. Obviously, like, everyone has to qualify every time you say that. Mm. Obviously, he wasn't perfect. Obviously, I wish the Twitter thing had been a little different and he would have had better people around him and everything else. But he was keeping the wheels on the car as we were veering off the road. And now we're like basically heading towards a ditch. What I would prefer to happen, rather than Trump, who also, I think he's 76 or 77 years old, it's like we've got to shift away from the baby boomer crew. We need a younger crew. What I would prefer to happen is that Trump acts as the advocate, keep doing the rallies, keep fighting the media, keep doing all the dirty work, be the bodyguard, so that, say, a DeSantis Tim Scott ticket maybe could get through. Let DeSantis, who I think is 43 years old, he's done an incredible job in Florida, he's willing to fight, but let Trump do the dirty work. Let him take the hits from the media. Let him draw the people to the rallies and go be the statesman, DeSantis. I know Florida wouldn't be
happy
to potentially
lose him. That doesn't sound like Trump. That doesn't sound like Trump.
No, it doesn't sound. I know. So hey, Don, if you watch Megyn Kelly's show, and I have no doubt that you do, my personal message to you is think about putting your ego in check for the first time in your life. Not because you're not right about a lot of this stuff, but because for the health of the country and for a true healing, not the way Biden said healing, which was this fake healing and where they really wanted you to heal like a dog, but for a true
That's
way to move
exactly
forward.
It. That was the second
moderate,
one.
Yes.
I
got
moment.
Two. All right. I'm taking tomorrow off. That's the way we can do it. That's the way we can do it. You would get, hey, look, and DeSantis will be treated horribly, of course, and all of the things that they said about, they'll call him a white supremacist, and they'll call Tim Scott a white supremacist, by the way, as they did with my friend Larry Elder. They'll do all of the tricks no matter what. But Trump could be the bodyguard. It would be the first time in his life that he would take that thing, say, hey, spotlight not totally on me, and let me see if I can do something a little bigger than me. I don't know that he can do it, but that, to me, that makes so much sense if we're going to get this thing right again.
The thing is, it's like, so there was just recently a poll that 44% of Biden's voters were voting against Trump. They weren't, you'll be shocked to learn they weren't inspired by Biden's campaign. I actually called, yeah. Oh, that's
it. Basements aren't usually that inspiring either.
President Joe Basement. It's not bad.
Yeah.
So 44%. So if you remove Trump from the equation, you could make the argument that those are gettable voters by a Republican. But the truth is, a lot of the people who did vote for Trump aren't inspired by the Republican Party in general and might not show up at all. Like, they might not like DeSantis. They may not feel motivated by him in the way that Trump had this special relationship with people to make them feel. So I'm not sure.